So hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to construct a use case diagram for online shopping system. I'm going to construct this entire diagram by using staruml, which is used to create this software engineering diagrams. So let's get started. Just open staruml and you need to go to model and go to add diagram, and you will have a list of diagrams over here. Just select use case diagram and the necessary objects to create use case diagram will be displayed over here. So I've already done a use case diagram for library management system. You can check that video also. So use case diagram, there are actually two versions of use case diagram. One is one-to-one, that is here we will be using only two actors, that is one is the user or the customer, and another one is going to be the shopkeeper or the shop owner. So this is the simpler diagram, I would say. And another one diagram will have multiple actors. This, the left hand side, the customers is going to be the common thing, but on the right hand side we will have like multiple operators, that is one will be a shopkeeper, one person will be for inventory, that stock management, another person for that accountancy, that statistics, profit and loss stuff. So you can also divide it based upon your marks that you have been allotted for that question. So now let's get started. So first we need to select the actor, okay? Just click it and click over here. So here will be our customer or consumer, okay? Our customer, and another one is going to be the shop owner or the shopkeeper. I will keep it as the shop owner, okay? Shop owner. W in here, okay, that's good. So shop owner we have, right? So next we are going to do the use cases. Since it's going to be an online shopping system, you know the basic stuff, okay? That register, online. So that's our, that are first needed. So first let's just go to the use case and just put use case and set it. The first one is going to be register, okay? So this register is going to be exclusive for customer, okay? Because shop owner would have been already pre-registered because he is the controlling the entire online system. So he's going to be pre-registered. So this register is exclusive for the customer. So it's always like good to have some exclusive thing, like your diagram must have some use cases exclusive for the customer also, exclusive for the shopkeeper also, and some use cases common for both the actors. So it should be a, like complete one, okay? So register is good, and let me just click and have multiple, okay? I don't want to claim. So next is going to be the login, okay? Login. So this one is going to be common for both the customer as well as the shopkeeper. Okay, this is a common use case. And next one is going to be search item. Okay, search item. This one is for the customer. Okay, because customer is only going to search the items, grocery or the things that are present in the online shopping mart. And next one is select or add item, okay? Add item to their cart, okay? Same thing that you do in the online e-commerce sites. So select or add item, this one is going to be for our customer, okay? And next one is going to be make payment, okay? Make payment, okay? Make payment is going to be again exclusive for our customer, okay? So that's good. And you can also have your like order history, okay? So I will just move it up. So we have got, I think, all the use cases are pretty much more exclusive to us customer. So if you may ask, what are the things that are exclusive a shop owner is, like we can also have like statistics, okay? Statistics on sales, okay? That is the total items that have sold and the profit, the loss, the monthly statistics, weekly statistics, like that. This one is going to be like exclusive for the shop owner, okay? Because he's one who is going to calculate all the profit and losses. So this is exclusive for the shop owner. And you can also have like this notifications, okay? Notifications, okay? So this one is also exclusive for the shop owner, because shop owner can send like the new products that are being added and the products that are favorite for the customer, and any discount, any special offers for functions and festival days, like that. That is, the notifications is going to be sent by the shop owner to the customer. So it's exclusive for the shop owner. This is being exclusively controlled by the shop owner. So notifications can be an exclusive for the shop owner. And another one is going to be inventory control. Inventory or stock control, okay? Okay, this basically involves like adding new products to your shopping mart. Suppose if a new product has been launched, you can just add it to the cart. So this is for the shop owner, okay, exclusive. And so I think this is good for one-to-one, that is a customer to shop owner use case diagram. Now let me just put the arrow mark, okay. So it's going to be customer is going to register, is going to be exclusive for the customer, and you have login also, and we also have search item. We have select on our item. We are going to have make payment, order history. I think that's it. This is all the things that basically the customer can manage order history. Okay, so now for the shop owner, login is going to be for the shop owner. Okay, and next one is going to be like sales and statistics is for exclusive for the shop owner, and notifications is for the shop owner, and inventory or stock control is also going to be an exclusive for the exclusive for the shop owner itself. Okay, so now this is good for one to one, but what if you want to like add more actors to your own, like you can add an actor saying that yeah, like a stats controller, okay, a person who just manages all the stats like the profit and loss, the amount of stocks available. So you can just add a person and you can like just put an arrow over here, and he's just going to take control over all of all the statistics and the stocks available in the super market system. And you can also add a person like to perform this all the banking and other payment stuff, okay, like payments manager. So he may also have like control over all the order history. Okay, once again. Okay, he may also have control over all the order history as well as the payment gateway that we are going to use. Okay, this is like in case if you have got something like really like you need to include many number of factors, you may do it. Otherwise, one to one is really good because we have got the things common for both the customer and the shop owner as well. We have some exclusive for the customer as well. We have some exclusive for the shop owner as well. So like one to one is really good. Suppose if you want to add more actors, you can just add these two, that stats controller and the payment manager, or those who just work on the payment and stuff. So I think this is really good for a use case diagram for online shopping management system. So I have done library management system. I have also done activity diagram and use case diagram, normal general version. So you can also check out that videos. And mine is a programming channel. I have done tutorials in C, C++, Python, Java, Blender, Unity. So it will be really great if you check other videos of my channel and subscribe me and support me. And thanks for watching.